Welcome back to Video View. Now, on my right, I have Glenn Gregory, and on my left, I have Joan Jett. Let's go straight into the next video then, which is Sweet Child of Mine by Guns N' Roses.
Because I didn't like it. I personally like that video. And it's not, I mean, I know it's been done a million times, you know, yeah. Live footage and the cuts and the black and white, yeah, and the grainy, yeah, look. But after a lot of the videos that you see lately, I mean,
you
to a certain point,
you knew all the words.
Yeah, she was singing
refreshing
along.
Also, it's a big hit in the States.
Oh,
so
right. It's number three in the,
yeah,
US chart.
It's going to
go number one next week,
before,
I think.
But I mean, I also see, this is what I mean. Compare this band to Europe. To me, that band
Europe
had some sort of attitude, yeah, or a passion.
Well, I did definitely like the guy's hat. He had a pretty keen hat there. The kind of, not Noddy Holder one, the other one.
Dave Hill.
Dave Hill, yeah, hat he had on there, yes.
Right.
That's why I left it on so long, just so I wanted to see more.
By the amount of bands that I see, you know, and it's just, I sense like such a lack of, you know, a lot of people go by the term being a rock and roll band, but very few live up to it. You know, it's like I never believed, you know, people say rock and roll is all attitude. I never really believed that until I started thinking about it, and I started seeing bands like Europe,
yeah,
saying that they're a rock and roll band. Mm. I mean, that to me, they're not. Mm. You know, and that seemed more like at least that they meant what they were doing. Mm. Whether or not it's a classic video is a different story.
Do you think you know that from seeing them play live or from just seeing that video?
No, though? I've never seen them play live.
Never seen them play.
No, I've only seen the video and I've heard
the
song.
I think rock and roll must be a planet that I've never visited because I listened to you there, and I just...
Well, that's a ballad compared to probably most of their songs.
Really?
There you go.
Well, there we have it, rock and roll in a nutshell. Well, as we approach the sixth video of this evening, we are now going to see Bruce Hornsby and The Range with Look Out Any Window.
No!
What was the name of that song?
Look Out Any Window.
What did Picking Up Dirt have to do with that?
Well, you know? Yeah, I mean,
Look Out Any Window, you see some...
You see,
picking,
yeah,
up dirt.
I just it made
Joan.
No, I know it's a joke, but it just did it grab you? It didn't grab me.
I mean, well, I mean Bruce Hornsby in The Range would
CNN.
Never grab me. I mean,
didn't The Way It Is grab you?
No.
This is The Way It Is.
No. I'm sorry. Bruce Hornsby in The Range definitely do not and never will grab me.
Mm.
You're going to get nowhere near me.
We've seen quite a few videos recently that have had that sort of thing. Now, I think what the idea was is that you know, if we'd have allowed it to go on, you'd have seen, like, one moment you saw the farmer in his field, then you have a picture of, like, a factory chimney,
right,
pulling out pollution, then you see someone, you know, pulling up shellfish, then you see, like, you know, trains going by.
I think you should get on with the next video because it's not worth talking about.
Yep, OK, well, Glenn, I'll take your cue.
Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, here we go. We're inundated with fantastic videos tonight, aren't we?
Yes.
We've got loads of them. That guy apparently was the guy from...
New Edition.
New Edition, yeah. He doesn't seem to have grown up much. There was nothing very real going on there, either in the video or the song, for me. It was just like maybe a song that someone's written for him in the kind of Alexandra O'Neill feel, you know, something. It's quite a kind of nice beat and a bit sexy, and but when you actually look at it, there's nothing really in there, you know what I mean?
Right. I mean,
that's why I left it as long as I did, just to check it out and see what was really going on.
Yeah, I was waiting to see if he was going to get out of the car.
Exactly.
I mean, like you said, I thought the beat was good, you know. But it really didn't do anything. It wasn't.
I agree.
Anything you know what I mean? Like nothing that you'd sit there and go, wow, let me check this out. Well, you'd want to watch it and see like little details.
You'd maybe hold hands to it, but you wouldn't get any further, would you?
Right.
Hands off. Well, listen, Bobby Brown doesn't seem to have got many marks tonight, so should we go to the final video?
Steaming.
Okay, steaming ahead. Then finally this evening, we have Kevin Rowland with his second attempt from his debut solo album. This track is called Tonight. I beg your pardon?
Excuse me.
Personally, I thought that was, including the one that I liked, the Guns N' Roses.
Right, right.
I thought I liked that probably the best as far as being creative, interesting. I probably didn't listen to the song as much as I should have.
Well, I think we're short for time, so we all pressed that, but I think we all liked that one.
Yeah, we would have liked to. I would have liked to watch more of it.
Yes,
definitely.
Me too.
Because I'm sure. I mean, there's a lot of wit in there. There was some humour in there, which is something you see so little these days in videos.
Everyone tries to be so serious.
Exactly, and even when they're being funny, it's like kind of Bob Hope funny, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's like, well, let's slap on the ass. It's not real, you know, wit.
Right.
But there was some, he was making fun of himself in that video.
Right, right.
And it was good. The song I haven't heard before, I only heard a little bit of it. It was nice. But definitely, that was a breath of fresh air. Now, maybe we should have just left it on and not even spoke, because I think it was...
Yeah, well, nice. I mean, we'll show it in full on the show anyway. But no, I think it's good because I thought Dexy's towards the end just got really bad. You know, they're turning out rubbish, I thought.
Right.
And, you know, it's nice to see, you know, he was with Dexy's Midnight Runners.
Mm-hmm.
And it's nice to see him, I think, sort of, you know, now doing it on his own. I think doing it really well.
I think he's got a lot of class. I think he stands up, he's an opinionated chap, and it comes out in his songs, I think. You know what I mean? He really does. Right,
maybe
what
now
he
what he's now he's on his own, right? So obviously it seems like he's got a chance to do what he wants to do. I mean, I'm not sure, but I'm sure.
I mean,
he
there
had
was
a lot
for instance, there was
in
a lot
that.
More the song before that, the kind of funky number. There was a lot more reality and feeling in that song, even though it wasn't a kind of, you know, like, you know, grind or whatever song. There was a lot more sex and love and and of everything in that song than there was in the other one.
Right,
you know, for
right,
sure.
I agree.
Reality.
Well, listen, Glenn and Joan, this evening comes to an end. Thanks a lot for coming in on Video View and giving us your views.
My pleasure.
Good combination. Well, that's a lot then for this week on Video View. Join me next week, same time, same place.